Hello and welcome to my maybe very first Minecraft tutorial, Minecraft Create tutorial, and today I want to show you how I have built a survival friendly, functional vault gate opening system. I can show it you quick. As you can see behind the wall, basically, is the gate opener moving. It will then stick to the door and open the bunker or vault if you want. Now, here we are. As you can hear, there is a alarm system to notificate everyone that the door is either opening or closing. If you press the same button again, the vault will close. Now, how have I built that? I have every item here in my inventory, which I will show you what I did now. How I have constructed all this. It's basically very easy. The most difficult part in the creation was to prevent button press spamming. Yes, now why did I want to prevent that button spamming? Because it would then screw up with the timing of the whole mechanism. Now, here we have, this is the first part, we have a signal blocker. As you saw, when I press the button, the piston will push the observer to the left, the observer will give a signal, and the whole system will get started. Now, here we have the normal piston, the observer here, an additional piston, here we have the redstone repeater, the vanilla redstone repeater, here we have the Minecraft Create redstone repeater, we have simple redstone dust, and redstone extender for the alarm. Now, there we have a redstone comparator, two additional redstone repeater, placed like a clock, around like a clock. For the alarm, I used the node blocks, a wool, a emerald block, and the same goes for here. Now, this is the alarm. Now, we will come to the timing later on, okay? How you are supposed to time everything. Now, going forward, we have the first timing mechanism. First comes the water energy generator. Here we have an additional redstone repeater, and Minecraft Create pulse repeater. Redstone, as you can see here, and then our very first redstone link. Now, this redstone link is set as a signal giver. It gives a signal through the diamond frequency to the redstone link receiver. You can change the mode of the receiver by clicking Shift and right-click. Yes, now, the redstone link activates the dispenser block, which has a water bucket inside. Now, this is the water wheel. It is connected with the shaft to the open, opener. Here we have a gantry, a gear shift, a lever just for manual use. Here we then have an gantry carriage, just normal vanilla blocks. You can build whatever you want. It's just for decorational purposes. Now we have the sticker block, an additional redstone link, which is the receiver, the lapis lazuli receiver from this third mechanism. Now, again, here we need an redstone, a pulse repeater, the redstone link frequenced for however you like. I gave it a lapis lazuli frequency. This one will activate the sticker to stick the door with it. Now, the redstone link in the middle. Here we have two pulse repeaters. One set for 16 seconds, the other one for 30. I'll explain later why. We have the emerald frequency, and the emerald frequency will connect the redstone link here above the gear shift mechanism for changing the direction of the gear of the gantry shift to move. Now, we have a simple sticky piston, as you can see, a normal redstone block, a lever for normal use, and the rest is already shown. Now, here we have the door, the vault, if you want. The netherite blocks are connected with each other with the help of the super glue, as you can see. Now, how do you use the super glue? It's basically easy. Now, all you have to do is hold it in your hand, press right click, and right click again. Easy. If you want to break the connection, you just have to press left click. Now, that is basically it. Now, what will happen with this combined? You press a button. The piston will move the observer to the left. It will give a signal to the system. The redstone repeater is set to 32 seconds because it will take roughly 30 seconds for the whole system to either open or close the vault gate. Now, the alarm is connected with a redstone comparator. It is set to 31 seconds. Those two are set to 5 ticks. Ticks are much faster than seconds. I can show you. See? 1 second, and below a second comes a tick, as you can read on the right side under delay. Now back to 5 ticks. Here we have 29 seconds, 16 seconds, and 30 seconds. What will happen? After the signal goes here, first will the water energy generator be activated. Then, after 29 seconds, it will be automatically deactivated. Here, for the movement, we have, after the generator is activated, the gantry shaft will rotate after 16 seconds, basically when the sticker block has been moved here, and then after the sticker block has sticked to the door, after 15 seconds, as you can see, then after the 16th second, will the redstone block be pushed down by the sticky piston, and the gear shift will then activate the different direction of rotation for the gate opener to move back to. Then, after 30 seconds, basically when the gate opener is back in its origin position, the redstone block will be pushed up again, and the gear shift will then maintain its normal rotation direction. And then, after 29 seconds, the water generator will deactivate. Now, again, for your better understanding, the first signal comes from the button, it will move the observer. The observer will give a signal to the system. The alarm, which will continue for 31 seconds with the help of a pulse extender, will make sound. First will the water generator be activated. Then, after 15 seconds, will the sticker stick. After the sticker, after 16 seconds, will the gear shift be switched to the other direction. The gate opener will come back, and then first will the water generator be deactivated, and only then, lastly, will the gear shift again be switched to the first state by the redstone block being pulled up again. And only then will, after the 31 second, the alarm be deactivated, and only then, on the 32nd second, will the whole system be resetted. And then you can press the button again, and a new signal can go through into the system and either close it or open it. Now, much important, the timing for every redstone pulse repeater can be different depending on how tall you will build the vault and depending on how long you will build the way for the opener to travel. So yes, you need to build it step for step. First the water generator, then the opener. You can later then, when you finished everything, you can then decorate it if you want. Yes, you have to build the energy, then you have to count on how long it will take for it to travel to the door, and then the same time goes by when it will travel back. You have to count the seconds and then put them here. First for going back and then for deactivating the gear shift. After the water generator has been turned off. Yes, the sticker needs to be counted after the mechanism has traveled to the door and before it will be sent back to the left side, if you know what I mean. And then, basically, if you counted everything right, you should be able to simply, after you have waited enough, counted how long the whole process will take, and then put the seconds here, after the alarm goes off, then you can basically press the button as much as you want, and nothing should break if you don't press the button indefinitely while the system is working. So yeah, one button for opening and closing the vault. As you can see here, water goes on, the opener travels to the door, then will the sticker be activated, and then will the redstone block be moved down, and the gear shift can then the opener travel back. Then, yes, the redstone will go up again, the water will be turned off, and the alarm goes off, and the observer will be resetted. Now, I hope you understood everything. If you have any questions, just ask them in the commentary section. Yes, that is my version. The vault door can, of course, be bigger, taller, or have a different form. And yes, you can have a different alarm if you want to, if you have a mod pack and there is a very beautiful alarm item, you can use that. Yes. So that is basically the whole thing. You can build it a little bit more compacter with less redstone if you want. That here is just for showing off. Yes, that is the whole principle. The standard idea, I would say, for you to build your own vault door opening mechanism. Basically, now you can build your own bunker or fallout map or something like that, whatever. But yes, that was it already. Like I said, if you have comments, if you have questions, write a comment. I will answer it as soon as possible. And yes, thank you for watching. I hope the tutorial isn't too confusing. It should basically be simple enough to understand. Thank you for watching. And if you like it, I can maybe make a tutorial and show you how I have built an elevator in my last stream. Yeah, thank you for watching. Leave a like up. Subscribe if you want. I'll be awaiting your comments. Goodbye.